First, I'm going to show you how to gain access. Go into your Steam, look up Pro Mod, and then down here should be like get access, and then they'll email you. So once you gain access, the first thing you want to do is obviously set your settings and whatnot. And then go to training, extras, and then strafe training. Because this is a big mechanic inside the game
Welcome to the Strafe Distance Challenge. This is a purely optional test for those who
that
really want to push the
is
limits of their strafe
need
numbers
to
with a
strafe jump to get
Every
to
jump
these
increases in distance and difficulty,
blocks.
and you can leave at any time by heading to the easy button
And
or hitting the escape key. Good luck.
how to do that is, if you know anything about strafe jumping, is you're hitting your W key and A and sprint, and also moving your mouse in that direction if you're hitting A. So A, you would go, this way slightly. If you're doing to the right, it would be D, also with like W. So it's kind of, without showing an overlay, the best way I can explain is, so W, and I'm going to be turning left. So it'll be W, A, and sprint, obviously. And you get this turn. See, I was too quick. D. So this is the good, this is a good corner to practice this on, because you don't want to, you want to barely miss this corner. And you see how I move my mouth as well. So when you strafe jump, you gotta do that all at the same time. Remember, WA and sprinting. See, I was pretty lazy with my mouse on that one, but I still made it, but it was really short. So let's see, be a little more aggressive with the mouse, but you still gotta be smooth.
That's it, keep going, you've got this. You make it look too easy. Incredible jump, well played.
How I'm more. So in walking or running in this game, if you run just in a straight line, it's not as fast as for strafe running. You gotta move your mouse just a slight direction. You're putting say, W A D A D, and I'm moving my mouse in the same direction when I'm hitting A D A D, obviously with sprint and W smash. But you get an idea of strafe running. Now, it's been a very long time since I've done this, so I'm really rusty. Like, Quake has this mechanic, and it's probably been a year since I've even done this moving mechanic. So I'm not consistent with it. So this is a good trainer to become consistent at, because to move around the maps super quick, this is needed. WA, because I'm turning left with the sprint, and I'm moving my mouse in that direction, and I jump towards the when once I'm facing the way or the direction that I need to go to. Another mechanic is strafing into the water to run faster. So W, A, and sprint. So if you see that again, if I just don't strafe into it, it's not as fast. I strafe into it. Come on. So here, let's place a marker. These are little jumpers, if you hit them. Right now, I think there's two maps, and it's pretty much like a search and destroy, 5-on-5. In this gameplay, I have a high ping because I'm playing like super early in the morning, and like there was no American servers. For a 5-on-5 search and destroy, it's a relatively fast-paced game because the rounds are really short and the maps are not big. Plus, when somebody plants the bomb, it actually encloses the circle down towards that bomb right away. Oh, so I have a really high ping right now because I'm not playing on an American server because it's really early in the morning.
Bomb planted. A.
So footsteps are really loud, so when you ADS, they get quieter, obviously, and when you crouch as well. I'm so scared. Yikes. Ooh. Who's on top? With the 212 ping on top. Yikes.
Switch inside.
So when the bomb's planted, the circle of the map closes in towards that bomb. Pretty cool feature.
Bomb planted. B.
Ooh, a little no scope action that actually works.
Clutch. Victory.
Did they say clutch?